Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC660 BBD110. This is a 16-point input, 115-volt AC discrete genius block, okay? So basically what this test is for is just to make sure that the block is working properly. It's a troubleshooting type test. And so the first thing that you can see in front of you is we have the block powered up. And I have a solid red light. If for some reason you guys power up the block in the appropriate areas with 115 volt AC power input and you don't get a light, then that obviously means that there's something catastrophically wrong with the block and it would likely need repair or replacement. Okay, now a few things that you guys are gonna need for this test that I wanted to mention is besides the 115 volt AC cord input, you're also gonna need, I have here a raw probe, okay? This is what I'm gonna use to touch all the terminals to make sure that each point works, each input works. The other thing, very, very important, is the IC660 HHM501 handheld monitor, as you see here, okay? And then, of course, in the rack that you guys are unable to see, I apologize for that, I have currently a IC693CHS3975 slot rack, and in that rack I have a IC693PWR330 high capacity power supply, an IC693CPU374+, and very importantly and much needed for this test, the IC693BEM331 Genius Bus Controller. Alright, now the Genius Bus Controller is connected right here to my serial 1 and 2 and my shield. Okay, as you can see, I have a shielded cable that's going in there. I'm using a 150 ohm resistor. That's going to be required to eliminate any noise distraction. And of course, my handheld monitor is plugged in right here under the monitor tab. Okay, so now once it's powered up, a couple things I'm going to do. I'm going to actually start this test in Prophecy Machine Edition. All right, and what that means is we're going to start configuring the Genius Bus Controller, and the reason that we want to have the bus controller working is we want to make sure that this block behaves properly with the software through the serial cable through the Genius Bus Controller. Okay, now as you can see here, I have the same physical configuration I mentioned before, the 5 slot rack, PWR330, CPU374, and our IC693BEM331. Now, on the BEM331, if you're following my arrow here, I'm going to go to, we have settings, I'm going to go to Global Data tab, and just for simplicity's sake, I'm going to take and double click, or you can right click, data entry tool, on block address number 1. And it's a 16 input discrete, so it's 16% I. Okay. Now we're going to connect up to processor by tap the online offline button, then we're going to go to toggle it online, that's the green handprint, and then we're going to pause here for just a second. Next thing I'm going to do, getting back to the handheld monitor, just so that we're all on the same page, I'm going to turn this on. The default baud rate is 153.6K standard. If you guys are using a different rate, make sure that you change that in here. You can toggle through all the different speeds. Okay, so like I said before, we're using the standard rate, 153.6. I'm going to select OK. Now the next thing is, just to make sure we're all on the same page, I'm going to go to F1, which is Handheld Monitor Utilities. F1, handheld monitor configuration. And I'm going to go next, next, and select the proper host. Now, before I was using something on an application for field control, which is this PCIM, QBIM Genius. So what I'm going to do is toggle that to Series 90 host. Okay. I'm going to hit enter. Now we should all be there. And go back to home. Press home. OK. configuration, F3. F1, program block ID. Now, my block number is 7, which does not match the block number 1, which is in Prophecy Machine Edition. So I'm going to select block, F2, and I'm going to change that to 1 and enter. Okay, and then once it's back to normal, it'll show you that block 1 is now set. I'm going to go back to home, configuration, configure block. Now the rest of this is the factory settings, 10 milliseconds. Next, 9 through 16, 10 milliseconds also. Threshold at 50, 9 through 16. Report faults, yes. Short detection, no. Open wire detection, no. Configuration protect, I have it disabled so that I'm able to make changes, but you guys can enable it once it's set the way that you want it. Okay, input filter time, 10 milliseconds, and that's for all channels. Okay, now, next thing I want to do is go ahead and get our processor into run mode. Now, what we're doing here is that we've reprogrammed this to be block number 1, and we want to be able to get the I/O enabled LED light on. Okay, that tells us that this is communicating with the software and the BEM, okay, the bus controller. Very important. So, in Prophecy Machine Edition, we're going to go to Target, Online Commands, Clear. We're going to clear our controller and I/O fault tables. Okay. Yes. And then we're going to download and run this basic configuration right here. Hardware configuration and motion and logic. Yes. And we want to start the controller and enable the outputs. If you look down below, you should be in programmer mode. The processor should be in run mode. The inputs and outputs are enabled. Configuration and logic are equal. And your processor, of course, should also be in run mode. Okay. This will work with other processors, of course, but the facts stay the same. It should still be reading like this. Now, if you aren't in run mode or you have a problem, take a look at your feedback zone and see if it's giving you an error. But otherwise, you guys should be here right now. And what I'm going to do before we go back over to the Genius block is I'm going to open up my reference tables, default tables, input. All right, and we're starting at 113. Which is right here. Okay, now jumping back to the Genius block for a moment here. This is part of the physical test, the actual probing of the inputs. So now we have an I/O enabled light on. That means that it's communicating with the Genius bus controller, which is good. We also want to make sure that all the inputs that are related to this block at this address are also reporting in our input table on Prophecy Machine Edition. Okay, that'll be the last step. So, again in the handheld monitor, we're gonna go to F2, Analyze, F1, Monitor Block. Okay, now as I probe each input, these zeros at the bottom of my screen here will change to a 1. All right. Now what you want to do is take your input probe, and I'm going to secure this to screw number 13. And now I have a live probe, a hot lead, that I can touch to all my inputs. Just for an example, I'm going to touch one of them. And as you can see, it's changed to a 1 under 1. A 1 under 2. Okay? Number 3 is on. Number 4 is on, and so forth. Number 5 is on. Now, the other thing, of course, is I'm putting the handheld monitor down so you can also see the reference on the block itself. Each channel is associated in gold here, 1 through 16, and each LED should turn on as you go through all the inputs. Now, what I also do is for the last two screws, that would be screws number 31 and 32, or terminal points number 31 and 32, I place a piece of electrical tape over that so I don't accidentally probe the neutral. Of course, you don't want to do that, because if you probe the neutral, it's going to short circuit and you're going to have a major problem. So make sure you put a piece of tape over there just for safety's sake. Now, getting back into the last time here, Prophecy Machine Edition. If you follow my arrow, the reference point begins at 113, is where the address was established, and I'll just show you guys that again in the bus address number 1, 16 input address beginning on 113. All right, so just pay attention to whatever it's telling you is the address. I'm going to go back to 113 where my arrow is, right here. Now what I want to do is I want to make sure that it's reporting these input values to Prophecy Machine Edition through the bus controller. All right, and the reason that we do that is we want to make sure that the serial port here, which is reporting to the BEM, is working. It's telling the program that there's an input that's been activated. And I always go through every single channel, make sure that they're all good, and I get a reading of a 1 telling me it's toggling on and off. Okay, so that's basically the test. This is a good working Genius block. I've got no problems with it. There's no flashing lights. It powers up. All the inputs work. The handheld monitor and the BEM works. It works with the Prophecy Machine Edition. Now, if any one of those things didn't work, what I typically find with these BBD110s to be a major error is if the resistor breaks and you're unaware of it, and it's been folded back and forth so many times that there's a break in the resistor. Sometimes the block gets distracted, or much more commonly, one of the inputs isn't working. So you go to probe it and turn it on and you don't have a light at all, and that's basically a blown input. Yeah, that's typically what I see that's wrong with them. So if any of those things are a problem, these IC660 BBD110 is a Genius block that we very commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.